Let's look at intra and intercompany asset transfers. Let's look at intra-company asset transfers. That is transferring an asset within your same company code. So this is within your internal company code. This is intra means it's going to be something like an internal asset transfer. So what are the reasons for these kind of transfers? Example, asset was created in the wrong asset class. Wrong asset class, that means initially, for example, you wanted to create a vehicle, you bought a vehicle and you want to create it in the vehicle asset class. But accidentally, you have gone and created it in the machinery asset class. Now, if it's okay if there are no transactions, then you can quickly delete that asset and you can create a new asset. But let's say you forgot and you actually gone ahead with posting some acquisition transactions, you have posted depreciation, then you can't delete that asset. So what you need to do, you need to still keep that asset, but you can do an internal transfer and transfer to the correct asset class by creating an intra-company asset transfer. Another option is, another example is, asset needs to be split. For example, you have a large piece of land and now you want to split the land into two. You're not going to sell that land, or you're not going to retire that land, but you just want to divide that land into two or into three, whatever ways you want to divide it into. So then this asset needs to be split. Then also you can do an intra-company asset transfer transaction. Adding materials to an asset. For example, if you are building a telecommunications tower or any other type of construction, you'll be buying materials and you're adding to that asset. So then you're not going to create a new asset, it's going to be the same asset, but you'll be adding more stuff to that asset. Then it becomes an internal or intra-company asset transfer. Now let's look at intercompany asset transfer. That is transferring asset from one of your group companies to another. And remember, for all any intercompany transactions or cross-company code transactions, they all have to lie within the same chart of accounts group or the controlling area. So example, you're transferring a vehicle from your head office to your branch. It's an example of intercompany asset transfer. Or you can transfer vehicles between your sister companies. Transfer of buildings. This is also very common, where you might have moved into your head office building and you're taking that head office building over. So that will be a transfer of building. Transfer of land. You might be giving one of your land to one of your sister companies so they can use that land. So these are all types of asset transfers within your group of companies. So it's called an intercompany asset transfer. Now let's look at these examples by creating this transaction in the system. Let's look at creating an intra-company asset transfer. Intra-company means within your own company. So the scenario is that you have bought a vehicle about 1.5 months ago, and you bought it and you created the asset master record under machinery. So instead of creating under the vehicles asset class, you have created under the machinery asset class, and you have used it for about 1.5 months. Then later you realized you have created in the wrong asset class. So now you have to create it in the correct asset class. So let's go through that whole scenario. First, let's create the asset AS01. It's a short transaction code to create the asset master data. So I'm going to choose the machinery asset class, which is the wrong asset class I have initially gone and created. So I'm going to use this, put the company code, give a description. So I'm going to create the vehicle Nissan Patrol and give a number plate over here, XYZ123. Copy the same thing. I'm just going to give a cost center over here, just give the basic information only. Depreciation area, just leave it as it is and save. Now I have created this asset 2001, which is my Nissan Patrol. Now I'm going to post acquisition with a vendor. You know the short transaction code is F-90. We have seen it earlier in our presentation. And let's say I bought it on the 1st of July 2015. I'm going to put the same dates over here. It's going to say Nissan Patrol intra company. Let's say Nissan Patrol here again. And choose the vendor over here. Let's select a vendor. It's going to choose RST company over here.